Hello and welcome everyone to the Unite Now session on navigating monetization in iOS 14. Thanks for taking the time to join us. My name is Camille Labat and I'm a Senior Client Partner Manager at Unity and also your lucky host for today. We're excited to have you join us as we have an important topic lined up as we'll be discussing the IDFA and ad tracking changes that are coming in iOS 14 and specifically how it relates to game monetization and game publishers. Throughout our discussion today, we'll touch on how Unity is helping publishers prepare for the changes and the strategy and planning these publishers are implementing. As this is a live session with limited time, we will not be taking questions during the webinar. If you'd like to ask any questions in the chat, we will work on incorporating responses into our publisher resources on unityads.com. Also joining us to share their experience of preparing for iOS 14 is Sean Thompson, the VP of Production at Mobile Deluxe and a fantastic publisher partner of Unity's. Sean has more than 16 years of experience working as a leader in game development and mobile advertising and has worked with pretty much every type of mobile monetization mechanic out there. Prepaid, subscription, IAP ads, you name it. Before we get started though, let's quickly go over our agenda. I'll be starting the discussion today with a quick refresher on the IDFA and ad tracking changes coming in iOS 14 and its impact on publishers. Next, I'll talk about how Unity is supporting publishers navigating this change with resources and tools. And finally, we'll get into our fireside chat with Sean on what strategies and planning Mobile Deluxe are considering as they prepare. With that said, let's get into our session. So first things first, let's start with the basics of iOS 14 ad tracking changes. What is changing? Why does it matter? And importantly, what does it mean for publishers? As I'm sure most of you know, IDFA is a unique identifier for advertisers given by Apple to user devices. It helps advertisers track data to serve customized ads to users without revealing personal information. The data can be used to determine which in-game events a user triggers and to attribute users' interaction with advertising campaigns. Right now, until the ads industry hears otherwise from Apple, IDFA tracking is available on all users, but they have given notice that the new iOS 14 will at some point require an opt-in action by any app users. The framework that is supporting the opt-in requirement is called AppTracking Transparency, or ATT, which presents the tracking request to users. Also changing in iOS 14 is that Apple has made available a new privacy-safe attribution framework called SKAdNetwork, which is set to be the attribution framework moving forward. SKAdNetwork changes what, how, and when attribution signals are sent to advertisers. It goes without saying that these changes are expected to have an impact on publisher monetization strategies. While the ads industry has been moving towards this for some time already, it has caused some uncertainty amongst publishers as the countdown is now on for Apple to implement these changes. While the overall impact on monetization remains to be seen, a few things we can expect include: opt-in rates will become an important goal and publishers will need to test and strategize for opt-in as the best way to continue with IDFA. Publishers will also need to start testing how they work with the new SKAdNetwork attribution framework, as this will be the framework of the future. Finally, as behavioral targeting becomes more dependent on tracking opt-in, publishers will need to start focusing on what contextual signals they're able to send to advertisers. At Unity, we've been preparing for increased privacy in the ad world for some time. And with iOS 14 news, we want to support a smooth transition for publishers and advertisers alike. Here's how we're supporting publishers right now. First, our newest SDK for Unity Ads is ready, which is version 3.5.1. It's built to be iOS 14 compatible by functioning with ATT opt-in flow and SKAdNetwork attribution. Unity also allows game publishers to test the user prompt experience prior to the enforcement of iOS 14's new privacy guidelines by providing access to iOS 14 APIs via packages and made with Unity games. Next, to support easy integration of plist files, we've made a portal for networks across the ad industry to submit their SKAdNetwork IDs to Unity. We currently have over 40 IDs aggregated into one plist file to make it easier for publishers to have all the common ones in place. If you're a partner from a network and you want to submit your SKAdNetwork ID to Unity for our plist, then you can do so on the Unity partner portal. For publishers looking to access the aggregated file, it can be easily found in the Unity Ads knowledge base in the iOS section under the SKAdNetwork subsection. Finally, a new feature we're working on that's coming soon will support reporting on ATT opt-in status. Specifically, we're looking to provide an idea of CPM for users with ATT enabled versus not to help publishers evaluate revenue impact of the different segments. All right, so now that we've gone over a bit of a refresher on what the iOS 14 ad tracking changes are exactly, what their impact might be, and some ways Unity is supporting publishers, let's get to the more interactive portion of the session. To hear about his experience firsthand, I am pleased to welcome Sean Thompson from Studio Mobile Deluxe to discuss how they are thinking about and preparing for these ad tracking changes. Welcome, Sean.
Hey, Camille. Thank you for having me.
It's our pleasure to have you join us. So let's start with telling our viewers a bit about yourself and Mobile Deluxe.
Yeah, so Mobile Deluxe is an LA-based studio. We've been around working in mobile for 20 years, so that's pre-iPhone. We go back to the flip phone days. We're focused on casual, and over the years, we've done licensed IP, we've done internal IP, pretty much across the board. Our most popular franchise is definitely Solitaire Deluxe, with over 20 million installs life to date for that franchise. For me personally, I am a VP of production at Mobile Deluxe. So my responsibilities range from overseeing app development to monetization analytics.
That's so impressive. Your team produces a lot of great games and obviously seen a lot of evolution in the mobile ad space over that time. You're the perfect guest to give our audience some insight. As you know, iOS 14 has obviously been the hot topic in the ads industry as of late. The iOS 14 update rolled out to developers in September, but the specific changes regarding user opt-ins for cross-app tracking permissions have been delayed until early next year. Before we get into the details, what are your general thoughts about iOS 14 and its effect on publishers?
Yeah, our first reaction was definitely, one of trepidation. Most of our revenue as a company comes from ads. So a big revenue drop, a 50% revenue drop, which is what people were talking about, would be a pretty big deal for us. Additionally, on top of that, Q4 is actually our biggest revenue quarter of the year due to the seasonality of ads. So seeing that happen in Q4 was something we were really worried about. So just on its face right there, moving it from Q4 to Q1 is already a win from our perspective, just because we keep that Q4 fully intact. And I also think more time for the mobile community is also a big win. So that's been a positive. Our second reaction was a little more inquisitive. Does our audience and demographic, does it work better with contextual targeting, which means we can actually hold our revenue better when the iOS 14 fully takes effect? We're also wondering if we can implement SKAdNetwork in such a way that it gives us a leg up on our competitors. So, that's what we pretty quickly got to was what can we do to make the most out of the situation?
Nice. Well, it sounds like you guys are asking the right questions, and I'm sure that many publishers watching have considered some of the similar things. So getting into a little bit more detail, how long would you say you've been preparing for the changes?
As soon as the change was announced, we started discussing it immediately with all of our ad partners. It became the preface to every single call that we had with an ad network is iOS 14, IDFA, SKAdNetwork. That was definitely the top of the conversation. From an actual timeline perspective, by early August, we were working on the plan for our IDFA opt-in flow. We were designing the screens, working through those mocks. By mid-August, we were working on SKAdNetwork design and had begun implementing it when all the rumors came out that the deadline was going to be pushed.
Nice. Well, it seems like the Mobile Deluxe team was certainly proactive, and I'm sure that preparedness will pay off next year, as you say, to kind of help weather the storm better than most. So moving on, I'm sure we're all curious about if your overall monetization strategy changes in any meaningful way as a result of iOS 14, or is it mostly just a matter of playing the same game under a few different rules?
Immediately our goal is to adapt as well as possible. We as a company are relatively nimble. That's how we've survived as long as we have, all the transitions that we've seen in the mobile industry. But ad monetization is absolutely our bread and butter right now. So we just keep optimizing to make sure we're maximizing revenue from that perspective. At an app-specific level, we are looking at our current apps at ways to boost the priority of subscriptions and IAP-related features due to this change. Additionally, we're looking at design changes that might tie into SKAdNetwork optimization, such as clearly defined funnel for evaluating conversion values, something we're very strongly looking at. At the broader company level, this absolutely impacts our roadmap and our strategy going forward. It has to play into it. So, we are keeping this in mind and watching the changes, and we'll just see how that impacts the roadmap going forward.
Definitely. Yeah, it sounds like those are some solid strategic moves. On a more nuanced level, can you share any key things that you've been doing or still plan to do in order to prepare for Apple's new tracking permissions early next year?
Yeah, it comes down for us to two key areas. We're talking about IDFA opt-in flow and SKAdNetwork optimization. For IDFA opt-in flow, we really have to balance the user experience with our goal of getting as many users as possible opted in. We're going to have A/B tests running with a couple of variations on it to find the right combination of messaging and timing to really get that balance right. for SKAdNetwork. We plan to get our implementation up and running and shipped this month so that we can run in parallel with the current user level attribution. We really think that'll help us to get SKAdNetwork optimized as much as possible before the user level attribution goes away.
Gotcha. Well, I'm sure this has been a massively collaborative effort at Mobile Deluxe. Who are the teams and some of the stakeholders that have been getting involved and getting you kind of as ready as you can be?
Yeah, it's been a whole team effort. Production and engineering are absolutely dealing with all of the in-app issues. So the IDFA opt-in design and implementation is 100% them. The SKAdNetwork design and implementation. And AdOps and UA are really also involved from a partner communication and a planning and a strategic standpoint. So it's been a whole company effort to get this ready.
Nice. Well, aside from your kind of internal teams, I'm sure you've had to also work with your ad supply partners to ensure they're ready as well. How have you been vetting or evaluating the readiness of the partners you currently work with?
Frequency of communication is key for us here. As I said, you know, it was a topic of conversation immediately once we started hearing about it. With a lot of our ad network partners, we have bi-weekly or monthly calls, so we can just continue to keep that conversation going. And we definitely noticed that some partners, such as Unity, are ahead of the curve and really pushing us to be ready for iOS 14, so we really appreciate that.
Nice. Can you share what have been some of the biggest challenges of the past few months since Apple first made their announcement?
The tight timeline. That was the biggest challenge. You know, for us to execute our changes and, you know, personally as a company and for the entire industry to really change how they approach attribution. This touches a lot of people in the mobile industry. So to try and execute that on a tight timeline was 100% the biggest challenge. We also, you know, there was that week or so where we heard private rumors and then public rumors about this getting pushed. And that was a little tricky for us as well, because we were really close to the deadline there. So we had to decide whether to continue making that, you know, our only priority to get it implemented, or whether we could actually work on some other high priority engineering tasks for our company. I would say the biggest challenge now is adapting our mental approach, now that we think we have a handle around the technical aspects of it, but the mental approach to how we approach attribution and making sure that we're optimizing as best we can. So we'll keep appraised of any changes that happen and continue to hone in on how we want to do this.
Yeah, so much adapting. So after these changes take effect, how do you plan to monitor or evaluate your performance? You kind of touched on that.
Yeah, so this is it. This is the heart of the matter. At the end of the day, we still need to evaluate cohort ROAS, return on ad spend, and we need to optimize our creatives and our campaigns. As it stands right now, we have the same data set and similar BI dashboards for that ROAS evaluation and for the creative campaign evaluation. And it is very granular. You know, we look at stuff on the user level and then aggregate it up as needed into the different slices. User level attribution allows KPI, key performance indicator evaluation against channel specific benchmarks. So we can actually look at our UA source channel by channel and evaluate their KPIs in addition to the campaign and creative level. And it helps us optimize UA spend both across sources and within sources. So we think it's pretty effective right now. In the future, it's definitely going to be a bifurcated approach. We're going to split it this is our current thinking. We're going to split it into two types of analysis. Our ROAS will move much more towards a full daily cohort evaluation. So we won't have the granularity of users within a day. So we will be looking at that day on the whole and what that return on ad spend looks like. SKAdNetwork and smart implementation of the conversion value should allow us to keep evaluating campaign, and we'll see about creative metrics from that perspective. So it's really kind of taking what is now a big mass of data that we're using for both of those things and figuring out how in the future we can use almost, you know, different data sets to keep both of those analyses going forward. The final product still remains TBD, you know, as we get to the actual onset of implementation, but that's where we are right now.
Great. Yeah, we're certainly hearing a lot about cohort evaluation, so definitely expect that to kind of continue as we move forward in this path. Nice. Okay, getting into our final question before we wrap things up. Are there any other key learnings you'd like to convey to publishers who might be questioning their overall readiness or scrambling towards the finish line?
I think the biggest thing is to take advantage of the resources that are out there, because there are some great resources on the current situation and the future situation. For example, Eric Supert puts out amazing content at Mobile Dev Memo. If you're not reading everything that he is posting on IDFA, you are making a mistake. You should absolutely go and check it out, especially talking about conversion value optimization, which is going to be one of the huge, huge factors for success when SKAdNetwork launches. So go read what he's talking about on conversion value and the way to set it up properly. Additionally, I would say Piggy and Sauls and John Cutts here, but all over IDFA, SKAdNetwork changes, they've got good stuff. I personally have a Twitter list of mobile people, which pops up some pretty good content. And just keep your ears and eyes open and watch for the conversation that's happening within the industry.
Definitely. Yeah. I follow some of those folks as well. That's some great advice. Definitely focusing on opt-in is certainly a strong way to maintain the IDFA environment for many, many publishers are accustomed to. So nice to hear that. Well, thank you again, Sean, for taking the time today to discuss this super important topic. And we hope we can have you again for another insightful fireside chat.
Oh, thank you, Camille. It's a pleasure working with Unity and very happy to be here.
All right. Now to quickly wrap up today's session, a few takeaways in summary. First, focusing on IDFA opt-in flow to try to get ahead of other publishers and to continue with enabled ad tracking. Second would be starting right away to optimize for SKAdNetwork, especially while you can still run comparisons to the current environment. Next would be staying informed on what's coming, when Apple will make the changes official and learning from what publishers and experts in the space are trying to do, per Sean's earlier suggestion. And of course, if you haven't already, do take advantage of support from Unity by downloading and setting up the Unity Ads SDK 3.5.1, which is iOS 14 ready, using our aggregated plist of SKAdNetwork IDs, and finally keeping an eye out for our ATT reporting feature, which will be coming soon and be widely available on the Unity monetization dashboard. Thanks. So we do encourage everyone to check out some of our additional resources in the Unity Ads knowledge base, which of course includes our iOS 14 publisher's guide and the plist and SDK links. That's it for today's Unite Now session. We hope you found it valuable and can join us again in the future. For more Unite Now sessions that might interest you, please visit resources.unity.com/unitenow to sign up. Thank you.